Hello and welcome to History Pod. On the 4th of October 1582, Pope Gregory XIII implemented the Gregorian calendar. By the 16th century, a sizable drift had developed between the Julian calendar, the lunar calendar, and the real moon. Consequently, the date on which the church celebrated Easter had begun to move away from the time that it had been celebrated by the early church. The Catholic Church disliked this seasonal drift, and so decreed the papal bull Inter Gravissimas in early 1582. This was intended to reform, or, in the words of the Latin text, restore the calendar to align with that at the time of the First Council of Nicaea in 325. 13 centuries worth of accumulated variations between the existing and new calendars meant that the change to the Gregorian calendar would lead to the deletion of 10 entire days. Consequently, in the territories that adopted the new calendar, the day after the 4th of October 1582 became the 15th of October, although the day of the week didn't change. The Gregorian calendar was originally only planned to be adopted by the Catholic Church and the Papal States, since to become a nation's official calendar it had to be approved by the civil authorities. Other Catholic territories did implement it on the specified date, however, such as those territories governed by Philip II of Spain and the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth. Many more Catholic countries adopted it soon after, but Protestant governments initially rejected the change. Despite this slow uptake, by the end of the 18th century, most of the countries of Western Europe, including the sizable British Empire, had switched to the Gregorian calendar to ease international trade. The Gregorian calendar is now the most widely used calendar in the entire world.